Hello everyone, this is Ashish Jain. This is another video on ongoing chapter audit and auditor. In the last video I have discussed in brief the entire section, that is section 139, which talks about the appointment of auditor. Now in this video we will discuss another section, that is section 140, which talks about the removal and resignation of auditors. Now the first section is section 140 clause 1, which talks about the removal of auditor before the expiry of the term. If there is a call from the company that the company want to remove the auditor before the expiry of his term, then every company need to follow this procedure. What are the procedure? First point is that there must be a board resolution. Then the company need to give application to central government within 30 days of board resolution, and they need to specify all the reasons under this form, that is ADT 2. Then they need to pass a special resolution at general meeting, which is to be held within 60 days of central government approval. And last point is opportunity of being heard should be given, which means dekhe, like अगर किसी को फांसी की सजा सुनाते हैं, उसको फांसी देने से पहले बोलते हैं ना कि आप अपने लाइक दो शब्द बोल दीजिए. सो लाइक इट्स सिमिलर टू दैट, लाइक द अपॉर्चुनिटी विल बी गिवन टू ऑडिटर दोज ऑडिटर दैट गोइंग टू रिमूव सून. ओके, सो दिस इज सेक्शन 141 दैट विच टॉक्स अबाउट द रिमूवल ऑफ ऑडिटर बिफोर द एक्सपायरी ऑफ द टर्म. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज सेक्शन 142 एंड क्लोज 3, which talks about the resignation and auditor, which means now there is a call from the auditor himself or herself. That means the auditor want to give resignation to the auditor. Now what kind of process they want to follow? First one is resignation auditor should file a statement in 30 days with the company and registrar of company, and they need to state specific reason, or you can say they need to intimate to a company that they want to resign under which form, that is ADT 3. Then they need to state some reason and other facts also in the statement. And in the case of government company, that means if the auditor is from government company, then the auditor need to give statement to CAG, as I told you in the last video also. Means whenever there is a government company, that means there must be an involvement of Comptroller and Auditor General of India, that is CAG. So in this case, suppose there is an auditor from the central government or any government company, then they need to give statement to CAG also along with company and registrar of company. And if the auditor fails to do so, then they will have to pay high penalty. The auditor need to pay fine of ₹550,000, maximum of ₹5 lakh, or remuneration whichever is less. The range of the fine, that is 50,000 to 5 lakh, is basically depend upon the misconduct. Means if any misconduct by the auditor, so it depends on the, or you can say if the auditor made any some fraudulent act. So it totally depend on the case. Okay, so fine basically depend on the case. Next, section 140 clause 4, which talks about the special notice to retiring auditor. Special notice here means that the company want to give a special notice to the auditor that they don't want to reappoint the same auditor again. I repeat, special notice here means that the company don't want to reappoint the auditor, means they don't want to reappoint the same auditor. Okay, now who will give this special notice? This special notice must be given by members. Who are the members? It depends on their eligibility criteria. What is the eligibility? Lower of the following, that is member who hold 1% of voting powers, or those who have paid up share capital of ₹5 lakh, whichever is lower, they are eligible for the members, and that means those members here means shareholders. Shareholders are the owners. That means these members have put the right to give special notice to the retiring auditors. Okay. Now, the question is, when the company is going to retire these auditors, or what is the procedure? Means when the retiring auditors has not completed 5 or 10 consecutive year of his term. As I told you in the last video, that there is a term, or you can say there is a tenure for the auditor, that they can complete their tenure till 5 or 10 years. 5 years in the case of individual and 10 years in the case of firm or LLP. And if the company want to, that means they need to give statement in the following ways. These are the ways. Means the company need to state that the that they want to appoint a person other than retiring auditor, and or they can provide express that the retiring auditor shall not be appointed again. Okay. Now, for the removal of for the special notice, they need to pass this special resolution at the annual general meeting, and before 14 days of AGM, members will give special notice to company. Who are the members? Shareholders. Now, last one is the retiring partner. The retiring auditor will give a written representation and request to circulate it to the members. That means here in the sense, that means the going auditor, or can say the retiring auditor will give a written representation. Written representation here means that means if the auditor want to disclose any information, and it should not be abused. It should not be abused by retiring auditor. Like I said, I have mentioned here written representation by RA. RA here means retiring auditor. Means it must not be abused by RA. And who will take this matter? कौन देखेगा इसको? That is tribunal. Tribunal will decide whether this written representation by retiring auditor is abused or not. If it is abused, that means abuse here means that auditor have disclosed some information that should not be known by all. Okay, means if it is not known by a member, that means it is abused. Okay. Now it is in the hand of tribunal. That means tribunal will decide whether this written representation is abused or not. If it is abused, then they will not circulate this to members, and they will not read out at AGM. And if it is not abused, then they will circulate this resolution to every member in the fact that WR here means written representation has been made, and they will circulate all the copy to its members. Okay. Now, however, if the copy of the written representation not sent because it was too late or due to some other reason, then auditor may make an oral representation also. Okay. Instead of written representation, they have an option for oral representation. Now, moving to next section, that is section 145, clause 5, which talks about the powers of tribunal to change the auditor. As we have talked about that the how to remove the auditor, that means if the tribunal itself want to change the auditor, that means let's take an example. Suppose an auditor who actually involved in any fraudulent manner, and if it is itself, if the tribunal itself give application, that means application given by following members, following people, suo motu here means tribunal itself gives application to the company and they want to change the auditor because the auditor involved in some fraudulent manner, and central government also give application to the company, or by any some other person also give application to company. First point here means if the tribunal is satisfied that the auditor has directly or indirectly acted in a fraudulent manner, then they can direct the company to change its auditor. And if the application is given by central government, then within 15 days tribunal will pass an order and the auditor shall not function as an auditor, and central government may appoint another auditor also. If the auditor found any kind of fraudulent manner, then they will be disqualified for 5 years and liable to pay heavy penalty under section 447. So this is the whole section 140, which talks about the retirement or removal of auditor. Okay, so rest concept we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.